Hello, my dear students. I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. And you all are completed your 80 marks paper of term 1 syllabus. And today onwards, we are going to start our term 2 syllabus. In that term 2 syllabus, we will complete first PA2 syllabus. In that PA2 syllabus, you will get chapter number 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. ओके आपके A5 चैप्टर से ये चैप्टर नंबर 10 जो है आपका इसमें था, ये टर्म 1 में था, हमने इसका स्किप करके हम ये टर्म 2 में मीन्स PA2 में हम ये ले रहे हैं. चैप्टर नंबर 10 नेम इज आवर ऑक्यूपेशंस, मीन्स हमारा जो हम जो काम करते हैं वो वाले होते हैं. ओके दो हम काम क्यों करते हैं, दे वर्क टू अर्न मनी, हमें हमारा फूड हमें खुद अरेंज करना होता है. फिर कैसे अरेंज करेंगे हम, तो फिर हम काम करेंगे तो हमें पैसे मिलेगा, पेमेंट मिलेगा, वो पेमेंट से हम अपना जिंदगी के जो भी जरूरत चीज़ें हैं वो खरीद के हमारा लाइफ को हम चलाते हैं. हाँ, और जो भी चीज़ खरीदने के लिए हमें पैसे की ज़रूरत होती है. Now we are going to start our chapter number 10 reading. Chapter number 10 are occupations. Have you ever thought why people work? They work to earn money and manage their life. Any work, whatever it is, that helps a person earn his livelihood is called an occupation. There are many occupations like teaching, agriculture, business, trade, etc. India is a big country and most of its population lives in villages, for example, rural areas. In this chapter, we shall learn about the main occupations of the living in the both villages and cities. Agriculture or farming is the main occupation of the rural people. Indian farmers grow many crops and vegetables, wheat, rice, pulses, jowar. Livelihood means of living, means of living. Rural, the countryside or a remote. So, page number 70, next para. बाजरा, मेज, सुगर केन, जूट, कॉटन, रबर एटसेट्रा आर सम ऑफ देम इन ग्रोइंग दीज क्रॉप्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स. सॉइल, क्लाइमेट एंड इरिगेशन प्ले एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल. फार्मर्स अर्न देयर लाइवलीहुड बाय ग्रोइंग दीज वेजिटेबल्स एंड क्रॉप्स इन देयर फील्ड्स. फैक्ट, राइस इज द स्टेपल फूड ऑफ द मेजॉरिटी ऑफ Indians. Rearing of animals, cattle farming. Cattle like cows, sheep, buffaloes, bullocks, and goats are reared. They provide us with milk and help us in agriculture. Sheep are reared especially for their fur. The woolen clothes that you wear in winter are made up of the fur. Rearing of animals for milk is called a dairy farming. We get milk from cows, buffaloes and goats. Milk and milk products are the main food items of the rural areas. Goat also provide us with the meat. Do you know cows and buffalo are milk animals? Can you name three things which are made of milk? Dairy farming, rearing of animals, milk animals means animals that give milk. Look at the picture of dairy farming. What do you see in it? This picture. Poultry farming. The following picture is the picture of a poultry farm. Hens, ducks and geese provide us with the eggs and meat. People rear these animals for their livelihood. Poultry farming. Fishing. The catch fishes is the main occupation of the people living near the coastal areas. Those who catch fishes for livelihood are called a fisherman. Fishes are also bred in tanks, ponds and rivers. Fish farm or fishery is a place where fishes are bred for sale. Every state has a fishery department. Breeding of fishes in fishery farm. Working in forest, a large area of India is covered with the forests. Many people depend on forests for their livelihood. They are engaged in cutting the trees for timber and they also harvest forest products. Trees are very useful to us. They are used to make furniture, matchboxes, forest products. Whatever we get from forest, 1 million means 10 lakh. Cardboards and paper, many people collect gum and rubber from the forest. Thus, forests provide work to millions of people. Mining, digging out minerals from the earth is called mining. You know, coal, silver, gold, copper, iron ore, etc. are found in the earth. Metals are the base of four industries. Marble and stone are also dug out from the earth. Millions of people are engaged in this work of digging minerals, metals and stones from the earth. Petroleum is a mineral found underneath the earth from which we get many useful things. Petrol, diesel, cooking gas and even Vaseline are the products of petroleum. Petrol and diesel are used as a fuels to drive trains, buses, cars and aeroplanes. Working in factories. The place where things are manufactured is called factory. The things we bring from the market are made in factories. Factories make small as well as big things using raw materials produced in farms or dug from the earth. Sugar is made from sugarcane. Cloth is made from cotton. These factories are called mills. Lakhs of people work in these factories. There are two types of workers in these factories: skilled workers and unskilled workers. Service sectors. Do you know how goods reach people? Suppose sugar is ready in the sugar mill. It is packed and loaded in trucks or trains and sent to the big stores. From the big stores, it is distributed to the shopkeepers, and from the shopkeepers, it reaches directly to the common man. Transport service plays a key role in transporting manufactured goods from one place to another. Thus, working in the service sector also can be an occupation. Other services such as a postal service, telecom, medical, education, travel, entertainment, publishing, the newspaper and books are some more professions. people working as teachers, doctors, carpenters, barbers, tailors, etc. All provide services, so these are also occupations. When you go to an office for any work, the people there are also serving you. Police and military people are also serving the nation. Can you name some other services? Quick review. Any work that helps us to earn money or livelihood is called an occupation. People living in rural areas are engaged in agriculture, cattle rearing and mining. Agriculture and mining provide raw materials for industries. Factories provide work to a large number of people. People in the service sector provide many services to men. Newspaper, a printed daily or weekly publication containing news report. This is our reading of chapter 10. Today you are going to write chapter 10 hard words in your FAIR notebook. Okay, take care and